Hey guys, I'm Chandni and you're watching The Art of Science. In today's video, we are going to look at some hydrophobic substances found around the house and understand the science behind them. Hydro means water. Hydrophilic substances like salt, milk, food coloring, paint are attracted to water and so they dissolve or mix in water. On the other hand, substances like oil, wax, grease are hydrophobic, which means they do not dissolve or mix in water. In fact, they repel water. One of the commonly found hydrophobic substances around the house is cocoa powder. You can try this for yourself. The cocoa powder is so hydrophobic that in spite of dipping the spoon inside the water, the cocoa powder brushes it off and comes out completely dry. You'll see a thin film of water over the cocoa powder. Looks like it's finally wet, right? Just poke this film with a toothpick or a wooden skewer and notice how it breaks, leaving the cocoa powder completely dry yet again. You can try it with milk for better visual effects. Please make sure that the temperature of the water and milk are cold. What happens is cocoa powder repels water and milk but attracts air. When we try to dip it inside water or milk, it creates an air bubble around it. The thin film of water or milk just sits on top of this layer of air, which does not allow the liquid to seep through the cocoa powder. On poking this with a toothpick, we break the surface tension of milk or water and let the air escape, resulting in the completely dry cocoa powder. Water just flows in all directions if it's poured on a flat surface. But what if I say that science can help you shape water in squares, triangles, circles, and even more cool patterns? It's not magic, it's just the art of science. Let's see how to do this. Take a block of wood or any other clean surface. Use a broad masking tape and cut out any shape you like and stick it. Next, take a candle and rub it on the surface. Remove the tape. Now, this entire block has candle wax except this shape. Start pouring water with a dropper and watch the water confining itself to this shape. The surface tension of water is so high that even after adding more drops, the water will still maintain its shape. This happens because candle wax is also hydrophobic in nature, so it repels the water and forces the water to stick to the area uncoated with wax. Hydrophobic sprays available in the market also contain substances that are hydrophobic in nature. The reason why these repel water is because the molecules of these substances are non-polar in nature. Non-polar molecules have a uniform charge around them, but polar molecules like water have a non-uniform charge around them. They have more negative charge concentration near the oxygen atom and a positive charge concentration near the hydrogen atoms. And this is why polar and non-polar molecules repel each other. Before we check out how to mix a hydrophobic substance with water, why don't you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Oil is another commonly known hydrophobic substance around the house. It never dissolves with water. But here's a DIY that you can perform to mix oil and water. We use dishwashing soap. Detergents and soaps have both hydrophobic and hydrophilic properties. And they use this property to remove oil and dirt from the clothes. That's why they are known as emulsifiers. The dishwashing liquid breaks the oil into smaller droplets and covers them with itself, which later suspends in the water, resulting in this oil-water mixture known as emulsion. I have linked the video up here and in the description box as well. If you try this experiment or have any doubts, let us know in the comments below and we'll see you next week.